Hello, spider peeps. Okay, so in a previous video, I'd introduced this little VGA monitor to you. So, hopefully you saw that video. And I was mourning about the fact that it doesn't have a battery in it. And I thought maybe there might be an opportunity to put one of these little battery packs which come out of old Mac batteries in there. So I've used this on previous occasions to do different things. Looking at this USB as well, so I thought I wanted to try and power it in there. So off Amazon, I got one of these little USB connectors just with tails. It obviously doesn't do data. So theoretically, if I plug that in and put 5 volts, I hope 5 volts through it, it should power it. So just an experiment today, really. This is just experimental to see whether I can do that. So let's put that out of the way a little bit. I think previously in another video I showed you this little thing, which is a buck boost converter, which you can put USB-C into and it will charge a battery for you and power stuff out of that battery. Let's zoom in a little bit. Struggling to focus on that actually. But we've got a battery plus and a battery minus down there. So we've got a plus and minus battery that can go into this there. So voltage out minus and voltage out plus at the top here. All right, so that's sort of how I've got to wire it up. So I think the first thing we need to do is work out the power, whether we've got any power in this battery. It should have been. I had charged these all up before I started playing with them previously, but it would be good for me to remember the voltages involved as well. So when I store these, I put Captain Tape over it to stop any chance of them shorting out. Let's, oh man, it's ice cream time. Why is it that whenever I start recording, I mean, the sun is out today. I mean, poor in the UK, we have had some rain. We've had roads closed, which is quite unheard of here. Some of the main roads have been closed, but yeah, it's been quite rough. But the sun's out today. And so because we're the UK, so is the ice cream van. But I'm not getting one today. Right, so let me just see what voltage we've got that. So yeah, so we've got 3.77, and that middle one, I think we've done this before, is positive. So I'm just gonna put that there, put that little bit on there so I don't get mixed up. Okay, so I think the first thing to do is wire the battery up to this and then see whether we get anything out of that. Voltage is a little bit low. So today I'll be using Yinfang electric wire kit. Let's get a little bit of red wire out of it. I don't actually need that much. And a similar amount of black wire there. And I'll be using this cheap but very efficient little wire stripper that I've had for a very long time today. It's two pieces of metal made in Taiwan. But very useful. I've got something else. I've got a few of these because they're so useful. They're no good as a wire cutter, but definitely they're good as a wire stripper. I'll just get a little block here, which will probably mess about with the camera. Now on these, I always really want to wire the battery up last. But on this occasion, I just want to see whether this will produce any voltage for me. Oh, let's get a little bit of flux on there. Should have used a slightly bigger tip for this. Preserve my fancy thin tip, but it's on now, so I'm stuck with it really. There's a few little whiskers on there. I'll give that a trim. I'll trim it away from here. There might be some decent power in here, so I don't want any solder splatters to fall on there. There's a little shaky there. That's what leads to dry joints. Of course, that had to be the wrong way around, didn't it? Typical. Okay, so this should be safe, I think. There's a little bit of copper on the edge of these. I'm just going to put a little bit of solder on the copper. Yeah. And I think that's far enough away from the battery that it's safe. Let's just tin these. And I should just be able to connect this up. Definitely need to leave that a little bit till it completely freezes. There we go. And this one. Okay, so my circuit board should be live now. So when I'm doing the other stuff, I must disconnect this. So I've got a live circuit board. So do I have any voltage coming out of it? The output was here, wasn't it? So anything coming out? Yeah, I've got 5 volts coming out. 5.5, exactly what I should expect. Lovely. All right, so I'm going to unsolder these again. Hang on, let's just check which was a positive on that. So positive is at the top again, so let's just put a bit of, it's not going on there, look. So I will unsolder the positive and unsolder the negative. So now let's wire in. I mean, this is really simple, really. This is barely a show and tell, isn't it? So let's put a blob of solder on that bit there and that bit there. Let's try again. So someone there. Don't know why, but I always like to solder the negative on first and then power up the system afterwards. Nice bit of nickel. That really takes the solder well there, I think. I assume it's nickel. All right, so this baby should be live. There's nothing hot in it. Let's just check I'm still getting voltage out of this. So our input voltage is 3.77, and then that 3.77 should be going into, yeah, and then out of this I should be getting 5.5, and there's a little adjuster. The best thing I can do is just plug it in and see if it works. Let's just go for it. I don't know what. Yes! Fantastic! All right, so this powers it. Brilliant. I'm quite surprised. And it had the blue screen as well. But this is exciting. All right, so let's just come back to this again. Now we've got that voltage coming in there. I mean, it looks like it's that it wants 12 volts in, but the USB works. Now I've got another little thing that I acquired from Amazon. Well, actually I think this was from AliExpress. So I've got a little thing here which will turn that. I mean, I probably could get a right angle USB, but these with the wires were useful. So really now all I need to do is find some way of mounting this battery onto the back of here. And I also need to do some tests to see how long this will keep the screen working for. So if I came in this way, let's unplug that a minute. That's gone in well. If I came in this way, obviously I'd have to sharpen up all the wires. But I wonder, would that battery fit under there? it just about would. So I might be able to make some form of enclosure. Obviously, I'll tidy these wires up and move this so that these are sticking on top of the battery, and could maybe do a little enclosure for it, or do a little enclosure that has something so that I can put the screw holes into the VESA screws, so it just comes over and captures one of those screws somewhere. I mean, maybe, got to be careful of the metal here, but maybe that way, and this just comes out the top. Yeah, I'd almost like design a little battery pack for that specifically, couldn't I? And also, we've got to see how long it will last. My next job then is going to be charging this and make sure that this charges. So if I plug this into here, I'm hoping there's some little lights. I think they're in the middle. And will this charge up? Yes. All right. So a little red light on there. All right. So we can see everything there then. So monitoring the power on that. So I'm just going to leave this recording and let's see how long it takes for the light to come on. And it's nearly at 4 already. And this isn't very hot. But yeah, let's just leave this and watch. Oh, nearly there. I mean, this will be an exciting video if I just upload it as is without editing and fast forwarding, won't it? Come to SpiderMaf's channel and watch a battery recharge. Yeah. All right, well, a little bit annoyingly, looks like that isn't going to change colour, but it's not going up higher. I mean, it went to 4.21 occasionally, but I think it seemed to, even when I was playing with this, it changed. Yeah, so now what I've got to do is work out how long this will power this monitor for. Okay, so I've got a little bit of a different setup now. Let's pop that back in, let's plug that in again. So I'm going to start to record this now, but I've got this little timer widget on the screen here on the Mac. So I'm going to press go now because it's still taking the battery power. And I hope I can record this without it timing out. Can I make it go big? Yeah. All right, so that's the timer now. I've got my Mac on power, and I think I've turned the screensaver off, and we'll see how much use I get out of this battery pack. So I will definitely have to fast forward this. So I'm pretty pleased with that. That lasted over 3 hours. I mean, that's a film and a half, isn't it? And 3 hours on one battery pack, that's pretty good going if you're using it as a monitor battery. I'm not sure if you were displaying a brighter picture on the screen, whether it would use more power, but I think actually 2 or 3 hours on just one of these is pretty good. All right, so I was just looking at this then. So let's turn this into something that's a bit more permanent then. So I've spent most of the afternoon 3D printing some enclosures for this to go in. All right, so that should fit in there perfectly. And it does. And then I've got another sort of lid that goes over that. So you see the battery tabs there will go through this hole in there. And then that will fit in there. And then I've got a final lid that goes on top of all of it, and I've just hot glued a acrylic rod in there just to act as a little light pipe So I hope that should work. So I've got to cut that down and I've got to stick this together. I think I'm going to hot glue this together at the moment. And the reason being is because I want to make this really low profile as I can get. And so I haven't put any extra space in for any clips or any fixing posts, screw holes, anything like that. And I can always just drop some IPA in it if I want the super glue to detach and take it apart for whatever reason. So I'm going to fast forward this, get this all set up. Don't think there's going to be an issue with this, but I just want to make sure. So just put a bit of Captain tape there just to stop that those touching anything on the side of the board. Okay, so I'm hoping this is giving out a voltage now, so let's just try it, make sure that I haven't broken anything while I'm doing it. Yeah, excellent. And then finally, I can just pop that little cover on there. So let's put a bit of hot glue on that, and I definitely want to do it around there where the wire is as well, just to make sure that that all keeps sealed in. All right, so I'm pretty pleased with that. It's really compact, isn't it? Tried to make it very, very low profile. And I've also got access to the USB charging port. So I can pop that in there and get the little telltales while it's charging to watch as well. So I hope you enjoyed that little project. I've definitely enjoyed doing it, playing with this screen. And also working out how to add a battery to it as well. So hopefully you'll see this starring in any further SpiderMaf videos where I need a little display screen on the desk. If you'd like to carry on supporting SpiderMaf and his channel, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing as well if you're not already. And I'll see you next time. Bye. Let's just put a bit of, it's not going on there, look. It vanishes. That must be warm. No, it's not. What is that? What is this?